Hey guys, it's Emily, and today I'm doing a book on haul because my sister Bethany is having a book drive at her school. So she picked a bunch of our books in the closet that we don't want, and then I decided maybe I should look through my books because I know that there's some that I really don't have any intention of reading again. And then I like my favorite books in the world, so I thought I'd get rid of them, and I got rid of a full shelf. So happy because I'm getting another set of the Harry Potter books. This time in the UK edition, so I need another shelf because I need one whole shelf for one set of Harry Potter books. I'm just looking over at them like I'm gonna have three shelves of Harry Potter books, and this is not okay. But I am also selling some of these to some of my friends because they want them, so I sell them half of the price that they normally are. So I'm gonna show you guys what those books are first, and I'm gonna show you all the ones that my sister Bethany is donating to her school. So I have two different piles because I two different people buying them, so I am holding them for them right now because they don't have money right this second, so I'm gonna hold it for them, and then if they don't give me money, then I'm just gonna sell them to someone else or give them away. So first one is The Lee's Ghost, and this one that I got from my library, as you see, it's kind of beaten up, and I got it because I thought it'd be interesting, but then I never read it, and realized I'm never gonna read it just because there's a bunch of other books that I'm gonna want to read before this, and it's about a sinister old house and a 50-year-old mystery with ghosts, secrets, and a both hilarious and creepy tale. Now, a lot of these that I have are Sunshine State Books. Sunshine State Books are this thing in Florida where there are 15 every year, and then there are different schools from each county compete against each other to see like what group of kids knows the most about each of these books, and they have ones for 3rd through 5th, and then 6th through 8th, and they only have battle books for 3rd through 5th, and I did battle books, so I have, I think, all of the books from the times that I competed in it. So first one is Athlete versus Mathlete. These are two twin brothers. One's an athlete, one's a mathlete, and I guess they're going against each other, and it says they're totally different twins. I barely remember what any of these are about, and they're, like, really short, and there's just a lot of other books that I'd rather read than, like, something like the Sunshine State books because they're for, like, 3rd grade, and I'm in 7th, and I'm never really going to read them again. And I know that if I reread them now, they're not going to be as good as when I read them back in like 4th grade, so I'll probably just get rid of them, and I'll donate them to, as I said, Bethany School. I'll give them to my friends, and they'll probably enjoy them more than I will. Next is 8 Keys, and this is about a girl who moves into a new house, and there's like this barn, I think, and there's like 8 different doors, and they're all locked, and she has to find the 8 keys to unlock the 8 doors, I think, and they each have a secret. Next, Double Dog Dare. This one was actually pretty good. It's about these two kids who go up against each other, see who can do the most dares, because they're both like known as like kings, like the king of dares. But they went to different schools, so now that they're in the same school, they go against each other. You can see here, I think she was dared to dye her hair green, and on the back, he was dared to wear tutu. And then on here it says, how far would you go to get something you really wanted? Would you lick a lizard, wear tutu to school, or dye your hair green? Like this book shows on the covers. Next is Kizzy and Stamps, and this is about a girl who is starting at a new school that just integrated public school, and she's worried about it, and she's worried that the white students won't like her, and that she's worried they'll stare at her scar that runs from the tip. From the tip of her right eye to the corner of her smile. Oh, now I remember she has like a scar. It's shaped like a crescent moon, I think, like around her face because she got like cut with some type of tool. I don't remember, but cover. Next is Nerd Camp, and Nerd Camp is about these kids that go to camp over the summer. It's for like the really smart kids and all that. I don't remember anything else about it, but it says that, I guess, the main kid, that was my alert, Jimmy just texted me, but it's about this kid named Gabe, who he doesn't really know if he's a geek or not, and apparently the name of the school is SCGE, which stands for Smart Camp for Geeks and Eggheads. So those are the ones for Jamie. Jamie keeps texting me, one moment. Okay. So the next book that I have for Jimmy's sisters, and this is My Sister's Vampire. Love Bites is the first book. I don't remember what it's about, but like one girl is normal and one's vampire. have the second book in the series, which is Lucky Break, same thing. One of them is Vampire, one of them is Normal. And I think they're being put in a play. Yeah, it says that they're being put in on a play, and it's the play Romeo and Juliet. And now this other one of Monster High books, this is School Friends Forever. I'm assuming it's like the first one. It's about all the girls in the Monster High series. It has like really big print. And it has a, like some illustrations in it. There you go. Like this one. Then I have, I'm assuming this would be number two in this series. And it is School Friends, Who's That Girlfriend? And again, it's about all the different girls in Monster High series, and, oh look, I think it shows the other books in the back. Let's see. Now that's School of Fear. I'm trying to find it.
They're on the back cover.
Oh, they're on the back cover too. But I guess the other ones are Girlfriends Forever and Girlfriends Just Wanna Have Fun, so I'm assuming this is the third one. Maybe the third one already came out. No, this is the third one because it says don't miss books 1 and 2. So I have books 1 and 3 in the series. I never read 2, so I don't really know if you really have to read that. Next is Ever After High, the Storybook of Legends. This is about the girls from Ever After High, which are the sons and daughters of evil villains and like princesses from, I think it's only Disney, so kind of like Descendants, I guess. But I have first book, and I have the second book, then Fairest of Them All. And then this one's my sister's, and it is Once Upon a Time, a story collection, so it has a bunch of mini stories in it. Yeah. They're not really big at all. So this one's that I'm selling, and then these are the ones Bethany's going to be giving to her book drive. This one is Penelope Crumb. I think this is about a girl who... Wait. I swore it was about a girl who, like, didn't know who her dad was or whatever. Oh yeah, but it looks like on the back it says she doesn't know who her grandpa is, so now she's on the look for him. Next is Island of the Blue Dolphins, and this is one that I read in, I think it was 4th grade, because we had this thing called MTSS, where for like 20 minutes each day, you would get in a group with like a different teacher, or maybe like the person was your teacher, and you would like do something. So in my group, we read books, and this one of the books that we read. And then at the end of the year, actually not the end of the year, my 5th grade graduation, they were giving out books, and all the girls got Island of the Blue Dolphins. I don't even really remember what it's about, so let's see. It says it's about a girl who's lived alone for years on an island of the blue dolphins. So I think it's this girl who, like, everybody in her, like, tribe is gone now, and it's just her and the blue dolphins. Next is Nancy Clancy Super Sleuth, and of course this is about Nancy Clancy. I used to love her when I was like 5 or whatever. And I had some of her other books, but I gave them to Bethany, and now those are gone. But this is, I think, the only one that's left. Next is another Sunshine State book, and that's Melonhead. And it's about a boy. Wait, I'm so confused now. Okay, no, it's about a boy who invents stuff, and for all 10 years that he's been alive, he's had great ideas that have been popping in out of his head, and sometimes they work and sometimes they don't. Says this year they better because our class entering inventing fair. So I guess he's going to fail with his inventions. Next one is The Chocolate Lab, and it's about a dog who goes to hit this new family's chocolate shop, and he gets into trouble. And this one I hated. This is Fake Mustache, and it's about this kid who, like, bought a fake mustache, and then once he bought it, he became, like, ruler of the world, and the only person who was, like, able to stop him and not under his control was his best friend. And I think this one girl, I don't remember what their name is, but now they have to try and stop him from, like, ruling the world and taking over the White House. Next is Draco the Magnificent, which actually has a Harry Potter reference in it. And I think it's about this kid who wants to be a magician, and he's doing the old-fashioned style with the hat and like bunny rabbit and things like that. This one I don't have the jacket for, but this is The Adventures of a South Pole Pig. And I completely forgot what this one's about. I know it's about a pig who goes to the South Pole, as it all explains.
I think I remember.
Benny thinks she remembers, but whatever. Next is when Light gives you OJ, and it's about a 10-year-old tries to convince her parents to let her have a dog, and everyone in Vermont owns a dog, and she's like the only one who doesn't, so she wants to get one, so the way she can like fit in. Next is White for Flying. Is this also by, I thought this girl's name was Zoe, and I was like, this girl's name is Zoe too, but they're not the same person. And it's a girl whose family rescues dogs in need, and there's this one specific one that I guess she really likes and wants to keep him. This print is huge.
Oh, wow.
Okay, next is Pie, and this is about a woman who has a secret, I think it's blueberry pie recipe, and she brings to like every single competition that she goes to and always wins, and then I guess she dies and she leaves it to her cat. And everybody has to try and find out what the recipe is. And it turns out that the Polly, who was the pie queen who had the famous pie recipe, left her cat, Lardo, who she gave the recipe to her niece, Alice. So Alice is trying to figure out the recipe from the cat. Next is Duke, and this is about a dog from World War II. And this kid who, his dad was in World War II, I think, because it takes place some time ago. And I think his dog had to go help in World War II, I think. I'm not 100% sure. Next is Freaky Fast Frankie Joe. And it's about a kid who lives with his mom. Then I think his mom gets arrested as law. And also her boyfriend gets arrested. So he has to go live with his father, who now has a happy marriage with like four other kids, and he doesn't really fit in with his four other brothers, so he tries to escape and go back to where he lives in the trailer park in Laredo, Texas. Next one is Hooper Finds a Family, a Hurricane Katrina Dog's Survival Tale. And 100% honest, I completely forgot what it's about, but based off the title, I'm assuming it would be about a dog who survived Hurricane Katrina and he goes looking for a new family and he finds one. But who knows, I may be wrong. So that's one pile. Two more. First is Magic Treehouse, number one, Dinosaurs Before Dark. And like, I'm never gonna reread it. There's so many like pictures, the print's so big. It's like 70 pages. I could finish this in like 2 hours. More like an hour and a half. So I don't really have a need for it. Next is Fortunately the Milk, and this is a pretty odd story. I don't even really know how to explain it, but it has like made up words, and it's about this kid who goes on an adventure, and he finds different things along the way, and he goes in this hot air balloon, meets this Stegosaurus scientist, and goes around and finds a bunch of things around because his father bought milk, and that's how the whole story happens. Next, this is one that I haven't read. Philippa Fisher, I think, is how you say it, and The Dreammaker's Daughter. So this is Bethany's book, so I don't know what it's about.
Oh, I didn't read it.
But it says on the back, Philippa Fisher is feeling lonely. She misses her fairy god sister Daisy. But while on vacation with her parents, she befriends Robin. Although Philippa is excited to have a new friend, she can't help but feel that there's something strange about Robin and her father. Meanwhile, Daisy misses Philippa too, so she decides to break the rules to visit her friend. Though the girls are happy to be reunited, things soon begin to go horribly wrong with Daisy's new assignment. And when all three of the girls find themselves in danger, Philippa must work quickly to save herself and her friends. So it sounds basically like a normal book where there's a hero and she has to save herself from herself and all of her friends from danger. Next is The Year of the Book, which is about this girl who is Chinese, and her best friend is Laura. She starts hanging out with these other girls, and like I guess she feels like her best friend's like leaving her or something. And that's all I really know about, but there is a sequel, And the sequel is The Year of the Baby. So it gets in the year her mom has baby. And I'm pretty sure the friends make up at the end, because in the cover for The Year of the Baby, the best friend's in the picture, like the cover of the book too, so I think that they make up. Next is Mind Rain, which is part of the Ugly series. And this isn't like the first book in any of the series. This is like something that happens like after the whole universe, so like whatever happens in the Ugly series. And I read like the first three chapters and I didn't really like it. Actually, I hated it. So I'm gonna give it away just because I don't really think that I would like the Ugly series based off of what I read in here. I just remember that there's two other books that I gotta, no, three more books I gotta give away, so I'm gonna have to grab those and I will be right back. Okay, so as I was pulling two of the books that I was gonna donate, Bethany tells me that they're too damaged to be donated, and they really are. So the only book I have is my Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows, and one of my friends does really want to read the Harry Potter series, and she said that she might buy it for me. I bought this for $33, and it's not even the copy that I wanted. If you guys haven't seen my Harry Potter series, all of them are bigger than this book. Actually, Bethany, if you could go get me one of my other Harry Potter books. This one, the cover is printed on, and the print size is huge, and it's shorter than all of my other books. I'm going to show you this, my example. This is my Harry Potter and the Half-Blood Prince compared to my Deathly Hallows. As you can see, Deathly Hallows is much shorter. There is a jacket on this one, if I could get it off. Let me smooth it up. Maybe you guys can tell, like, there's a jacket on it. There you go. There's a jacket on it, and the print size is way smaller. I'm used to reading print about this size. I don't know if you can tell, but I ordered this Harry Potter book online because I couldn't find it in store. In the stores that I went to. And I didn't read that the description, or even if the description did say this, that it was large print. And I could not read it this way. I had to like read it online because I couldn't read it this way. It was just too like weird for me to read. So I'm going to donate this to my friend, and then the money that she gives me, I'll probably buy the copy that I actually want. But if not, I can donate a Harry Potter book. Next one that I have is Waiting for the Magic, and this one wasn't a Sunshine State book, but in third grade we were reading them and we didn't have enough time to finish all of them and compete in Battle of the Books. So when we got to the end of the year, all the books that we had left were too big for us to be able to finish, because we had a meeting once a week where we would talk about the book and discuss it, and then we would have like a page that we had to read to every week. So we wouldn't have enough time for that, so we just picked this book called Waiting for the Magic, and it's about a kid and all of his like animals after his father leaves. And I think the animals start talking to him because there's a bunch of magic that starts like going around. So I think that's it for that one. And the next is Stranded, and this is written by the host of Survivor, and it's about four kids who get stranded on an island where a family vacation becomes a test of survival, because it's four kids, and I believe two of them are 100% biological, like two and two, and then altogether like step-siblings, and they're planning to go on this vacation together, but then a massive storm hits them without warning, and they land in the jungle with no adults and no instructions. Next is The Sasquatch Escape, and this is about these two kids who, I guess, find a Sasquatch who escapes from the zoo, because there is no description on this book. And it says, oh, it's about some kids named Ben and Pearl. But I guess they find this Sasquatch, and I think he likes chocolate since he's eating a chocolate bar. And I guess they try and help him escape, or maybe get back to the zoo, I don't remember. But it looks like there's a book too, and it's called The Lonely Lake Monster. Oh yes, it says on the back, beware, the Sasquatch is always hungry, especially for chocolate. Next is Third Grade Angels, which I don't even know what this is about, but I guess about some kids who are in a teacher called Mrs. Sims class. Go to competition every week to see which student deserves to be awarded the halo, which is the best behaved, kindest to others, and in short, perfect student of the week. Last in this pile, because there's still one more pile left, is Olivia being Trivia Queen. So about this girl who always watches Jeopardy, like Bethany does, and they have a Kids Week, so she gets picked to go on Kids Week. Last pile. First one is iCarly, I Am Famous, which is a book about iCarly. And there's sequels to this, and then there's also like pictures from the show in the book. Next is an I Survived book, which is I Survived the Destruction of Pompeii. And it's just like all the other I Survived books, and it's really short. And it's not as big as I thought it was going to be. Next is Kingdom Man, which is about a kid who has polio. And his dad is really mean to him, but he wants to be a baseball player. So I think he meets a baseball player, and this baseball player like teaches him, whatever. Next is Alien in My Pocket, which is about a kid who wakes up and finds like an alien, and then puts him in his pocket, and then has to hide him from everybody except for his obnoxious neighbor, I think, who finds out. Next is Confectionarily Yours, Something New, which is the first book in a series called Confectionarily Yours series, about this girl who bakes, and I guess this time she has to bake for her grandma's wedding, I believe, and she has a bunch of other distractions happening while that's going on. So I want to find you one of the recipes that she has. Here it is. Okay, so there are recipes all throughout the book. So like this one's for sesame buttercream, and there's also some for like cupcakes and things like that. Yeah, because then there's one for honey sesame cupcakes, so she has like a whole recipe for the whole cupcake in general. And let's see, what else does she have? If I could find one, that would be nice. I can hear my mom laughing in the background. Okay, so these are like pistachio cupcakes, and then after that, you have pistachio buttercream frosting. So she has like a whole recipe for each of these things that like match up all that. Next one is Elvis and the Underdogs, which is one of the first books that I read when I started reading Sunshine State Books. But this boy, I think it's about the boy who gets the dog. I think it's the one middle. I think these are his two friends. And then something like the dog has to be taken away or whatever. He has to try and get the dog back. Next is one that I didn't really like. It's called The Hero's Guide to Saving Your Kingdom. It's about a bunch of different heroes from all different types of life, and they try and do like save their kingdom. And then do normal things that like basic heroes do. And then there's a sequel, I think. Yeah. It's The Princes and it says The Princes and Princesses Are Back. Can They Find Happily Ever After Again? It says The Hero's Guide to Storming the Castle. But I didn't really like this one, so I never read the sequel anyway. Next is The Adventures of Beam Boy. This one I completely forgot what it's about, but there's a comic on the back about the kid. And there's comics in the book. Like, here's the comic. And then, I think it's about a kid who creates a comic about a superhero that he makes up called Beam Boy. I think that's what it is. And then this is the last book that I have, and it is called The Hypnotists, and it's about this kid who has these powers that he uses with his eyes, I believe. And it says, is it a gift or a curse? It's about a kid who has color-changing eyes that make people do things that they don't want to do. And at first, he doesn't know what he's doing, temporarily hypnotizing friends, foes, and strangers. But his power pushes things way too far, and his secret isn't a secret any longer. And I think he tries to get help from like a scientist, or like scientists try to see like why these things happen to him, but I'm pretty sure they can't figure it out. But there are like pink like spots all over. I don't know if you can see. Well, that's because whenever I'm coloring, my desk is not very flat, because I like whip stuff up and off of it. So I have to use a book, and the book that I picked the first time was this one. So whenever I do it, I just pick this one so I don't damage any more books, and now I'm giving it away. Mana's not like bad damage. You can just see like some pink spots on it, but it would be fine. And to donate. Okay. So I'm gonna show you guys kind of an overview of these piles of books that I have now. So that is it for today's video. Put in the comments below if you read any of these books, being that any of them sound interesting. See you guys in my next video. Bye!